Today, in accountancy, I'm going to sum up the chapter 3, admission of partner, and in that process, from the day one, we completed various topics related with admission of partners. The first was the meaning of admission of partner, then condition of reconstitution of partner, then why the new partner required, what are the adjustments at the time of admission, goodwill valuation, goodwill treatment, change in profit sharing ratio, that's why new partners calculation new ratio, or as well as sacrifice ratio, then revaluation account, partner's capital account, and then balance sheet. So we completed all the topics related with this unit. In the partnership class 12, that is the main unit because it contains various topics from calculating profit sharing ratio, sacrifice ratio, valuation of goodwill, treatment of goodwill, then revaluation, partner's capital, then balance sheet. In the exam, one question of 8 marker also from this unit, my dear children. Be careful. Concentrate more on admission. Now today, I am going to sum up this chapter through PPT, and I am sure you all will enjoy this topic, learn by the easy way, and if you have any doubt, we can keep it for further classes. The admission of partner. First topic, sacrificing ratio, old ratio minus new ratio. And new ratio is equals to old ratio minus sacrificing ratio. Sacrificing ratio refers to the ratio in which the old partners surrender their share of profit in favor of new partners. So sacrificing ratio is equals to old ratio minus new ratio. Now my question is, why we should calculate sacrifice ratio? Yes, please. Why we should calculate sacrifice ratio? Give the condition. Because we have to distribute the goodwill which is done by new partner in sacrifice ratio. So sacrificing ratio refers to the ratio in which the old partners surrender their share of profit in favor of new partner. Now come on to the goodwill. See, goodwill is an intangible but not fictitious assets that accounts for the excess purchase price of another company. On that time, I gave you the example that goodwill is the extra value of the business. So that accounts for the excess purchase price of another firm. Now, treatment of goodwill. When goodwill is paid privately. Goodwill is paid privately means the partners have mutual understanding and they don't want to show it in the books also. So that is paid privately. If they don't want to show in the books, then no need to pass any entry. So when that line is given that goodwill is paid privately, no need to pass any entry. But write the note that because goodwill is paying privately, no entry required. Now case B. When the new partner claims a share of goodwill, or when the amount of premium brings in cash and change in the business. Children, my dear children, this is the common condition. Okay, this is the common condition that the new partner brings his share of capital as well as he brings the goodwill in cash. Okay, but sometimes a new partner is unable to bring it goodwill in cash, then at that time you have to open current account. Okay, and the fourth condition, some part of goodwill in cash, some not in cash, then there will be entry. Okay, this is the entry. Then when goodwill appears in old balance sheet, that should be write off. Yesterday I explained you that old goodwill should be write off in old partners in old ratio. So old partners capital account debit to goodwill, and that goodwill will be distributed in old partners in old ratio and write off, because old partners don't want to share that old goodwill with the new partner. Okay. Now see the entry. When goodwill brought in cash or to bank account debit to new partner's capital account for capital and PFG, because he is bringing amount for goodwill as well. So this is the common condition. Just now I told you, no? This is the common condition that bank account be debited by new partner's capital account as well as new partner's PFG, because he is bringing goodwill in cash. Very good. This is the common condition. Now come on to the next point. If new partner does not bring his share of goodwill in cash, yes, it may be possible. New partner is unable to bring goodwill in cash, then in place of cash, because he is not bringing in cash, so in place of cash, what we have to do? Yes, very good. Open current account. Yes, so now current account. Now next, if new partner brings only a part of share of goodwill in cash, then part will be in PFG and unpaid share will be in current account. Okay, unpaid share means this method, only partly in method, is the combination of brings in cash and not brings in cash. So you have to pass this general entry. Then when goodwill withdrawn by old partners. Simply follow the rules of class 11. Okay. See, who are the receivers? Sacrificing partners. What is going out? Cash or bank is going out. Simply, so sacrificing partners capital account debit to cash or bank. But children, be careful. Maybe in the question, full goodwill is not withdrawn, partly withdrawn. See that point carefully. So see, the part they withdrawn, you have to pass the general entry by that amount only. Now, new concept. When the new partner brings his goodwill in kind. If that is in cash, it's very easy and it's very convenient. But if goodwill is bringing in kind, something, some asset he is bringing, no need to worry. Just in place of bank or cash, you should write assets account debit. Okay, my dear children, no need to worry. Just in place of bank, you should write assets. Okay. Now when goodwill is hidden, that is the concept. Okay. Goodwill is hidden. How do you know that is hidden? The hint is given in the question. When value of the goodwill of the firm is not given in the question, but it is to be calculated on the basis of the net worth of the firm. Hidden goodwill means the value is not given clearly. That's why it is known as hidden. So what to do? Look at the screen. Net worth, including goodwill, on the basis of contribution made by new partner. The net worth, excluding goodwill. So the difference will be termed as goodwill, which is known as hidden goodwill. See, simply A minus B. Net worth including goodwill minus net worth excluding goodwill. That will be value of hidden goodwill. Now children, come to the main topic, that is revaluation account. As I told you, the revaluation account is the basic account in the partnership, because at the time of change in profit sharing ratio, admission, retirement, death, every time revaluation is necessary. It is necessary to reassess, revalue the liabilities and assets. So revaluation account is prepared. It is a nominal account. It is also known as profit and loss adjustment account. Children, my dear children, that question in the exam also came, that prepare P&L adjustment account. Don't worry, P&L adjustment account and revaluation account both are same. So it is prepared. Why it is prepared? Revaluation. It is prepared to record the revalued figures of assets and liabilities, both. If you are entering change in asset, you have to enter the change in liabilities also. So, revalued figure of assets and liabilities at the time of change in profit sharing ratio, admission, retirement, death among the existing partners. So, how to prepare the revaluation account? I gave you one keyword. DI. Decrease in asset and debit side. You have to learn by only one word. Decrease in asset and debit side. Depreciation. Reduction. All things you have to enter in debit side. See the screen. Decrease in asset and debit side. If you are entering decrease in asset in debit side, it means increase in asset in credit side. It's very easy. Decrease in asset in debit side, it means increase in asset in credit side. Now reverse it. Increase in liability in debit side, decrease in liability in credit side. And you can use it for provisions also. Now, my dear children, that side balancing figure will be termed as profit on revaluation. This is balancing figure, and that will be distributed among old partners in old ratio. And if there is the balancing figure, that will be loss. Loss on revaluation will also be distributed among old partners in old ratio. Now, on the basis of revaluation account, we have to pass these general entries, because from many years the question is pass general entry. So, children, first you have to prepare revaluation in your working note, because without revaluation, how can you come to know the profit or loss? Yes, so come on to the general entries. See, concerned asset account debit to revaluation account if increase in the value of an asset. See, concerned asset means what? If there is increase in the value of land, what will be the general entry? Land account debit to revaluation account, and you have to write being the increase in the value of that order. My dear children, it's my request to you, make the proper format as well as Write the narration also. Now come for decrease in the value of assets. Reverse it. It's easy way to learn. Don't panic. Just work smart. Learn first entry and make accordingly. See, decrease in the value of asset means revaluation account that will be concerned. Asset account being the decrease in the value of an asset recorded. Now I am giving you example. When at the time of revaluation of assets, it was found that the value of furniture decreases by 1,000, past general entry. So what you will write there? Revaluation account debit to furniture account. Being the decrease in the value of furniture recorded. Then next, increase in the amount of liability. My dear children, many times at the time of revaluation, partners came to know that they have liability, maybe interest liability on bank loan. So, revaluation account debit to concerned liability account being the decrease in the amount of liability recorded. Those who want to note down the general entries, they can. But this is the basic. First entry is the decrease in the amount of liability. You have to reverse the entry. Then recording and unrecorded asset. Children, that question came in one marker question. What will be the entry you will pass at the time of admission of the partner if they found one unrecorded asset? Unrecorded asset account debit to revaluation account, like first entry. Next, for recording and unrecorded liability. At the time of admission of partner, when they are revaluing the assets and liabilities, they found that there is one unrecorded liability. Now, what they have to do? Revaluation account debit to unrecorded liability with the same as increase in the liability. Same, but you have to write the name. And if there is loss, in the firm, then old partner's capital account debit to revaluation account. In place of this, you have to write A's capital account debit, B's capital account debit to revaluation account. Be careful. Don't include new partner. New partner will not share this profit or loss. Okay. Now, when to write current account? This is the question. See, there are two methods of keeping capital accounts. One is fixed method, another is fluctuating. See, if there will be fixed method in partner's capital account, you have to pass the general entry through current account. Why? Because in fixed capital account method, partners keep their capitals fixed. They made two accounts, one for capital and another for current. Current account for other general entries. Now, a profit. Just reverse it. Revaluation account debit to old partner's capital account. Profit on revaluation account transferred to partner's capital account in old partner's old ratio. And if that is given in the question that they are following fixed capital method, don't write capital account in general entry. In place of capital, you have to write current account. Now, tomorrow I will explain you reserve and all of it. My dear children, for general entries, make the revaluation account in working note. Then accordingly, with the help of account, you have to pass the general entry. Now I am explaining you to account. First and revaluation account debit to decrease in asset. So revaluation account debit to asset for decrease. Now asset account debit to revaluation. Narration, increase in the value of asset. Then revaluation account debit to liability if liability increases. Liability account debit to revaluation if liability decreases. In this way, you have to pass the general entries. In the exam, if they give the question, pass general entries, you have to pass the general entries. And in the question, prepare ledger or prepare account, you have to make the account. See, if you make the accounts and don't pass the general entries, and it is mentioned in the question, then they will not give you marks. So first, read the question carefully. Okay, so from revaluation account, you can pass these general entries. And I am sure you all must understand what today I explain you. Summary through PPT, chapter 3, admission. This is a very vast chapter, including many topics. From calculation of profit sharing ratio, sacrifice ratio, goodwill methods, average, super capitalization, then goodwill treatment, privately, in cash, not in cash, partly in cash, then revaluation account, then partner's capital account, then balance sheet, then distribution of old reserve, write-off of old goodwill. So there are various topics included in this topic. So today we completed here about 50% of this chapter, and tomorrow we will continue it.